Welcome to Warn. Today's news is Indian Navy looks for its next fighter like Jet Rafale, F-18 or Gripen. At a time when the global power and strategic equations are under focus, India's defense sector has seen a major fillip in the last few months. However, last month Navy Chief Sunil Lanba said the present naval variant of the LCA does not meet the carrier capability requirement of the Navy. He said the service would continue to support its development but at the same time, it will seek aircraft elsewhere which can operate on the aircraft carrier. The two major reasons for the Navy's decision to float the tender as envisaged by IDN are the following: 1. The current batch of INS Vikramaditya carrier-based MiG-29K/KUBs are facing severe serviceability and maintenance issues, some of them are apparently falling apart. 2. LCA-Navy does not posses the capability of foldable wings which eats up into the precious real estate on the carrier. This is a reasonable stand taken by the Navy as backing the Tejas should never come in the way of Navy's defense preparedness. Force level preparedness is a dynamic and continuous process based on various factors. Notably, India's problem is accentuated because it involves contiguous border with more than one nation, wherein two of them are hostile. Clearly, optimal use of our war resources dictates that lethality is focused on these inimical states. The conventional wisdom in dealing with the problem is to equip our forces with strategic counter-offensive capability. All efforts should be made to ensure availability of assets as per requirement. Nonetheless, in DRDO's defense, it did take the Navy time to tell them whether they needed the aircraft to be designed for the ski or catapult operations. The CNS mentioned the LCA being overweight and not suitable for carrier operations. However, the Navy amended its decision to include 46 LCA Mk2 fighters if the empty weight could be reduced by 15% of 6.6 tons to 5.6 tons. Currently, the max weight is 13.5 and can carry up to 3.5 tons of missiles and bombs. Internal fuel is 2.5 tons and that can be increased by at least 40% viaduct drop tanks. More than a decade after its last procurement of fighter jets, the Navy is now all set to add teeth to its armory by acquiring 57 jets capable of taking off and landing from aircraft carriers. The Navy has floated a global tender in this regard. At present, the Navy has 45 MiG-29K jets for operations from INS Vikramaditya and the under-construction carrier INS Vikrant. However, the Navy does not intend to procure more MiG-29s given its troubled history. The competitors are supposed to respond to this big-ticket procurement by May this year. The Indian Navy has launched a global search for maritime fighter jets it plans to operate from future aircraft carriers and is awaiting response from top military contractors on what they have to offer. The Navy wants 57 multi-role carrier-borne fighters, MRCBF, and the potential order could get bigger with an option clause to buy more jets. The hunt for new deck-based fighters comes at a time when the Navy is left with just a solitary aircraft carrier, INS Vikramaditya, following the decommissioning of Virat on Monday. The Navy issued a request for information for the multi-billion dollar MRCBF project in January, giving aircraft manufacturers a four-month deadline to respond. By May, the foreign firms have to answer queries on technical parameters, budgetary estimates, likely level of indigenization, transfer of technology and schedule of deliveries after a contract is inked. French, Swedish, Russian and American firms are likely to compete for the project to equip India's future carriers, Indigenous Aircraft Carrier, IAC, I or Vikrant being built at Kochi and IAC, 2, which is in a conceptual stage. The Navy has rejected the naval version of the light combat aircraft. It wants a twin-engine fighter with a stronger airframe and landing gear to operate from a flight deck with high-tempo flying cycles. HT gives you the lowdown on the planes that could fly from a future Indian carrier. Rafale M, French aircraft maker Dassault Aviation will compete for the MRCBF program with the Rafale M fighter. These fighters are embarked on French Navy's nuclear-powered aircraft carrier Charles de Gaulle. India signed a $8.7 billion deal with France last year for 36 Rafale warplanes for the Indian Air Force. Dassault is hoping the IAF order could give it a head start. The firm believes it makes better sense to equip the IAF and the Navy with the same platform, as it would translate into better logistics, maintenance and industrial support. Gripen Maritime, Swedish aircraft maker Saab will throw its hat into the ring with its Gripen maritime fighter. Saab says the maritime fighter has 95% commonality with the Gripen A. The Swedish firm is closely tracking an IAF program to build single-engine fighters in the country. Saab says the maritime fighter features all the capabilities of the Gripen E and will come with a highly competitive operational cost per flight hour. Low maintenance requirements and high availability for operations make it an ideal solution for the Indian Navy, a Saab spokesperson said. F-18 Super Hornet, U.S. defense giant Boeing's F-18 fighter jet is also expected to be a strong contender for the Indian Navy project. The F-18s operate from American supercarriers such as USS Nimitz and USS Ronald Reagan, with the U.S. Navy accounting for a fleet of more than 600 Super Hornets. The American firm is also in discussions with the IAF to set up a production line in the country to build twin-engine fighter planes. The U.S. has offered its Electromagnetic Aircraft Launch System, EMALS, technology and advanced arresting gear for IAC, 2 or Vishal. India and the U.S. have formed a joint working group on aircraft carrier technology cooperation. MiG-29K, Russia will be eyeing the project with the MiG-29 fighter jet, already in service with the Indian Navy. The deck-based fighter operates from INS Vikramaditya, a second-hand carrier bought from Russia. The Navy commissioned its first squadron of MiG-29K fighters at Goa in May 2013, ahead of the induction of INS Vikramaditya. It also plans to deploy the fighters on the IAC, one having placed separate orders for 45 MiG-29K fighters. Thanks for watching. Please like and share. Please comment your opinion for this news. Press subscribe button for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.